Hello, my dear students. I am your Shurmi Miss. Hope all of you are doing well and passing a good time with your family. So today I am going to start my first online class, and the topic is algebraic formulae and application, which is chapter 5 of your textbook. This is a very important chapter for you, and today I will show some formulae and corresponding problems from this chapter. And you must memorize all the formulae very well and practice the maths at home. So without any delay, let's start. So in this chapter we have to know some formulae and some corollaries. So there are only three formulae, which are a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, and the second one is a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square, and the third one is a plus b plus c whole square equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ca. So we have to know only these three formulae for this chapter, and there are some corollaries. You can see the corollaries here. So the corollaries can be used only to find the value of any kind of problems. Okay, from here you can note the corollaries and formulae, and you have to memorize these things. Okay, so today I will show you the application of formulae only, and in the next classes I will show you the application of corollary. Okay, so without any delay, let's start. Okay, for showing the application of the formulae, I will solve some problem from the exercise. So let's go to the exercise 5.1. I will solve the first math of the exercise, which is a plus 5. Then we are asked to find the square of the terms with the help of formulae. So for that we will rewrite the expression and we'll give a square sign over here, and then we will apply the formulae a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. So I have written the formula over here. I will take the first part as a and the second part as b. Then I will apply the formula a square plus 2a and 5 as b plus b square, and after the simplification I will get a square plus 5 to the 10 a plus 25. This is the answer. Okay, now I'm going to solve another problem from this chapter, which is number 6. In number 6 they're given a number 990. Now we have to find the square of 990. So we can easily find the square of it. We can write it as 990 multiply 990, and the answer is 980100. But it's wrong, because there is no use of formula. In the question we are asked to find the square of the term with the help of formula. For that we will write the number again, and we can write 990 as 1000 minus 10. If we subtract 10 from 1000, we will get 990. So here we got a minus b. We can take the first term 1000 as a and the second term 10 as b. Then we can apply the formula a minus b whole square equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Now after applying the formula, we got 1000 square minus 2 into a, that means 1000, b, that means 10, plus b square, that means 10 square. Then after simplification, we got our answer 980100. This is the answer. Now look at the first method and the second method. Both answers are correct, but the first method is wrong because there is no application of formula. So we have done with the first two formulae. Now we'll see the application of the third formulae, which is a plus b plus c whole square. For that, I will solve problem 16, which is 2a square plus 2b minus c square. So now we have to find the square of the expression. Okay. To solve the math, we'll apply the formula a plus b plus c whole square equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus bc plus ca. Now we will take 2a square as a and 2b plus as b and minus c square as c. We can see that in the formula all the operators are plus. For that we will write the expression as 2a square plus 2b plus minus c square as c. After applying the formula, we can write 2a square whole square plus 2b whole square plus minus c square whole square, because we took minus c square as c, plus 2ab, 2a square dot 2b plus bc, 2b dot minus c square plus ca, minus c square 2a square. After simplification, we can write 4a to the power 4 plus 4b square plus c to the power 4. If we take the square of any negative term, it becomes positive, plus 2 4a square b plus, no, it's not plus, minus c square. Here the power is 1, that's why minus c square will be minus. Then we will multiply plus 2b minus c square, so it will become plus minus minus 2b c square, and the next term will be same like 2b square bc square minus 2a square c square. So students, I'm done with the application of three formulae. Now we will solve simplification. Problems 17 to 24 are simplification. For simplification, I will solve problem 17, which is 2a plus 1 whole square minus 4a, 2a plus 1 plus 4a square. Now I will simplify it. I can write 4a as 2 dot 2a and 2a plus 1 plus, I can write 4 as 2 whole square a square. Then 2a plus 1 whole square will remain same, 2. As 2a plus 1 is the first term, then I will take 2a plus 1 as first term and I will write 2a and then 2a whole square. Here we can apply the formula is a minus b whole square. So 2a plus 1 is a and 2a is b. So now we will apply the formula. 2a plus 1 is a minus 2a whole square. Then 2a plus 2a minus 2a, so these two are vanished. Then we get 1 square, that means 1. This is the answer. So after simplification, we got only one term. Now I will solve another simplification, which is 22. 3ab minus cd whole square plus 9 cd minus ab whole square plus 6 3ab minus cd minus ab. So the first term will remain same, 3ab minus cd whole square, and we can write 9 as 3 square cd minus ab whole square, and we can write 6 as 2 into 3, and the rest term will remain same. 3ab minus cd whole square, and here 3 square and cd minus ab square, so now I can write it as 3 cd minus ab whole square. As we know that a plus b whole square equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square, we will rearrange the middle term, I mean 2ab, as 3ab minus cd 3 cd minus ab. For better understanding, I will rearrange the terms. Now we'll apply the formula a square plus 2ab plus b square. So 3ab minus cd is our a, and 3cd minus ab, this is b. So we can write it as 3ab minus cd plus 3cd minus ab whole square. After simplification, we can write 3ab minus cd plus 3cd minus 3ab. 3ab plus 3ab and minus 3ab will be vanished, and after doing subtraction, we got 2cd whole square. Then 4c square d square will be the answer. So, dear students, that's all for today. Thank you for your participation. In my next class, I will solve the rest of the problems of this chapter. Till then, stay safe and do practice more and more. Bye bye.